Good morning, students. My name is Shachi teacher and I am going to teach you maths. Last time we have learned how to find the prime factors. Today we are going to learn how to find SCF by prime factors method. Right. Before starting the method, just remember first point. If one of the given numbers is a divisor of all the others, then it is the SCF of the given numbers. Example is, three numbers are there, 2, 14 and 16. Now, 2 is the factor of 14 also and 16 also. So, here SCF will be 2. Now, next point. If no prime number is a common divisor of all the given numbers, then 1 is their SCF because it is the only common divisor. Third point, 2 is the SCF of any two consecutive even numbers. Example, 14 and 16. So, common divisor will be 2 and it will also be the SCF. And 1 is the SCF of any two consecutive odd numbers. Understood? Now, keeping this in mind, we will start practice set 12. Here, question number 1, find the SCF. In this question, there are some sub question. So, odd number question I will solve, even number question are for homework. First one, numbers are 25 and 40. So, first what you have to do, you have to find the prime factors. So, you are going to find the prime factors of 25. Now, 25 is odd number, so it is not divisible by 2, right? We will divide this by 3. Can you divide this by 3? No, you are not able to divide this by 3. So, we will see next prime number. Which one is the next prime number? 5. See, in unit place, 5 is there. So, you can divide this number by 5. 25 divided by 5. What will get? 5. So, here also 5. So, factors of 25 are 5 into 5. Right? Now, we will find the prime factors of 40. Okay? Prime factors of 40. Now, 40 is a even number or odd number? Even number, right? So, you will divide this by 2. What you will get? 40 is divided by 2. What you will get? 20. Now, again, 20 is divided by 2. What you will get? 10. 10 is also divisible by 2. So, you will divide by 2. What you will get? 5. Now, 5 is divisible by 2 or not? No. So, we will divide it by 5. 5 and 5. So, factors of 40 are 40 is equals to 2 into 2 into 2 into 5. Now, you have to see the common factors between 25 and 40. Which are the common factors? 5 is common between 25, here also. So, HCF will be what? HCF is product of common factors. HCF is product of common factors. Now, here only one common factor is there. So, HCF will be 5. Answer is SCF of 25 and 40 is 5. Understood? Now, next question. Third one. numbers are 40, 60 and 75. Now here three numbers are there. So you have to find out the prime factors of all the three numbers. So first we are going to find out prime factors of 40. 40 divided by 2, you will get 20. Then 20 divided by 2, you will get 10. 10 divided by 2, you will get 5. And 5 divided by 5, you will get 1. Right? Here you have done that. Then you are going to find out prime factors of next number, that is 60. So 60 is also an even number divided by 2. 60 divided by 2, what you will get? 30. Then 30, again it is even number divided by 2. What you will get? 30 divided by 2. What you will get? 50. Now, can you divide 15 by 2? No. Because it is odd number. So we will try with next prime number, that is 3. Can you divide 15 by 3? Yes. So we are dividing 15 by 3. What you will get? 5. Now 5 is prime number, divide by 5 only. Right? Then next number is 75. Now it is multiple of 5, we will divide by 5. What will be your answer? 75 is divided by 5. What you will get? 20. What you will get? 75 divided by 5. 7 divided by 5, what you will get? 7 vanja. 7 vanja is, and then 2 will remain here. So 15. Your number is 15 now. 15 again divided by 5. 15 divided by 5, what you will get? 3. Divide by 3. Okay. Now you write down the prime factors. 40 is 2 into 2 into 2 into 5. 60 is 2 into 2 into 3 into 5. 75 is 5 into 5 into 3. Now you have to see the common factors among all the three numbers. See, 2 is here, 2 is here, but 2 is not in 75, so you cannot write that number. Then 5, 5 is here also, 5 is here also, 5 is here also, right? Again, if you see, 3 is in 60, 3 is in 75 also, but 3 is not present in 40 number. So that also you cannot write. Okay, so LCF is what? Product of common factors. LCF is what? Product of common factors. But here only one common factor is there, that is 5. So LCF will be what? LCF will be 5. Understood? Then next number. Next question is 5th one. 18, 32, 48. Now if you see, all the numbers are even numbers, so all numbers will be divisible by 2, right? So first we'll take 18 divided by 2. 18 divided by 2, what you'll get? 9. Now 9 is odd number, divide by 3. 9 divided by 3, you will get 3. Then next number is 32. Even number, divide by 2, what you'll get? 16. Divide by 2, what you'll get? 8. 8 divided by 2, what you'll get? 4. 4 divided by 2, what you'll get? 2. And 2 divided by 2, you'll get 1. Then next one is 48 divided by 2. What you'll get? 24. 24 divided by 2. What you'll get? 12. 12 divided by 2. 6. 6 divided by 2. 3. 3 you can't divide by 2. So you divide by 3. Again you will get 1. Right? So now you are going to write the prime factors. 18 is equals to 2 into 3 into 3. Then 32 is equals to 2 into 2 into 2 into 2 into 2. Then 48. 48 is equals to 2 into 2 into 2 into 2 into 3. You can recheck here. See, 18. 2 into 3 into 3. 2 into 3 into 3. Then 32. 5 times 2 are there. Then 48. 2 into 2 into 2 into 2 into 3. Check. 4 2s are there and 1 3. Now HCF. HCF is what? Product of common factors. Right? Now you have to see the common factors, which is present in all the three numbers. 2. Then 3. 3 is here, but 3 is not here. So can you write that 3? No. So here also HCF is 2. Understood? Now you can write the answer. HCF of 18, 32, 48 is equals to 2. The next number is, next question is 7th question. Numbers are 42, 45, 48. So first we are going to find the prime factors of 42. 42 is an even number divided by 2. What you will get? 42 divided by 2. 21. 21 is odd number. So you divide by 3. 7. 21 divided by 3. What you will get? 7. 7 divided by 7. You will get 1. Next number is 45. This is divisible by 5. 5 9 ja is 45. 45 divided by 5. You will get the answer 9. 9 is divisible by 3. 3 3 ja 9. 48. So again 48 is divided by 2. What you will get? 24. 24 divided by 2. What you will get? 12. 12 divided by 2. What you will get? 6. 6 divided by 2. What you will get? 3. 3 divided by 3. 1. Now you write the factors. First number is 42, that is equals to 2 into 3 into 7. Then 45 is equals to 5 into 3 into 3. 48 is equals to 2 into 2 into 2 into 2 into 3. Now you have to see the common factors, right? You have to see the common factor. What is common here? 2. Check 2. Here 2 is not present. So next number. 3 is here. 3 is here. 3 is also here. So we will write 3. 7. 7 is here but 7 is not here. So HCF is what? Product of common factors. But again here only one factor is common, that is what? 3. So answer will be what? HCF of 42, 45, 48 is equals to 3. Understood? Now, ninth question. Numbers are what? 56 and 57. You just remember the rule. 56 and 57 are consecutive numbers. So their HCF will be 1. Understood? That region you have to write. 56 and 57 are consecutive numbers. Therefore, HCF is equals to 1. Understood? Answer. HCF of 56 and 57 is equals to 1. Okay? Now, we will use another method of finding out the HCF. Right? Another method is known as division method. There are certain rules for this method. First rule is you have to see the two numbers. Whichever is bigger, that number should be divided by the smaller one. So first rule is what? Divide the bigger number by the smaller one. Second, divide the previous divisor by the remainder in this division. Then next step is divide the divisor of step 2 by the remainder obtained in the division in previous step. Continue like this till the remainder becomes 0. The divisor in the division in which the remainder is 0 is the HCF of the given numbers. Right? Now we will solve the sums, then you will understand. Question number 2. Find the HCF by the division method and reduce to the simplest form. So first one, here also odd numbers I will solve. Even number you have to solve. Question is 275 and 525. Now out of this, which one is bigger? 525 is bigger, right? So we will divide bigger number by the smaller number. So bigger number is 525. So 525 divided by 275. Right? How many times it will go? Only one time. 525 minus 275. What you will get? Subtract 5 minus 5, 0. 12 minus 7, what you will get? 5. And 4 minus 2, 2. Right? Now, this will become your divisor and previous divisor will become your dividend. So, here 275 divided by 250. How many times it will go? One time. So, 250. 275 minus 250. What you will get? 5 minus 0, 5. 7 minus 5, 2. Now, previous divisor will become your dividend. 250. Now, 250 you are dividing by 25. How many times it will go? 10 times. You have to divide this till you get the remainder 0. Right? Now, you got the remainder 0. Previous divisor will be your HCF. Now, here HCF of 275 and 525 is equals to 25. Now the next part of the question is reduce to the simplest form. For that, numerator and denominator both should be divided by the HCF. So 275 upon 525. Both the numbers will be divided by 25. When 275 is divided by 25, what you'll get? 11. When 525 is divided by 25, what you'll get? 21. So reduced form is what? 11 upon 21. This one is the reduced form. Understood? Now third one we will solve. Second one is for homework. Numbers are 161 and 69. Now which one is the bigger number? 161 is the bigger number. So 161 is divided by 69. How many times it will go? 2 times it will go. 69 2 ja is what? 138. Now subtract this, what will get? 11 minus 8, 3, and 5 minus 3, 2. Now this will become your divisor and this will become your dividend. So 69 divided by 23, right? How many times it will go? 3 times. 23, 3 ja is 69. You will get 0. You have to solve this till you get the remainder as 0. Now previous one will be your SCF. So SCF of 161 and 69 is equals to 23. Reduced form. Both the numbers will be divided by 23. Both the numbers will be divided by 23. When 161 is divided by 23, you will get 7. When 69 is divided by 23, you will get 3. So reduced form is what? 7 upon 3. Understood? Again, I am telling you students, in this practice set, odd number I have solved, even numbers are for your homework. If you have any doubt, you can use school's website, students portal. Hope you understood this exercise. Thank you.